Welcome to the Full Earth Workshop. Great day to climb up on top of it, pump your fist, and say, oh yeah! This is part four of a fun series where we repop a Cox slot car with parts from Electric Dreams and the Model Car Garage. Let's get to it. Ooh, we have new toys. Let's check and see what we have. So fun opening these boxes and seeing what plethora of fine details we have for our slot car. First of all, we have lots of tires, and they're from a company called Slot Cars Tires. And I purchased them from eBay. I'm really impressed by the quality. They are formed on both sides, and you'll see that compared to other tires that are out there, they are of supreme quality. As these cars are approaching about 60 years old, you'll notice the tires on most of the originals have started to crack and just fall away. And it's kind of difficult sometimes finding front tires for these cars. You should really get to know a company called Electric Dreams online because they have an excellent supply of vintage parts, new parts, and they leave nice little notes for you when you order things, which is very cool. Now, these are tires that are replicas of the original. Now, they're only one-sided, as you'll see. As I turn it over, you'll see, not too attractive there, but I think when you install it on your slot car, you're really not going to pay a whole lot of attention to the inner surface of these. But overall, very good quality. First ones were Goodyear. These were Firestones. Well, here's proof that I'm getting really nerdy in my old age. I'm getting some photo-etched Zeus fasteners. These were the fasteners that were used during the 60s, early 70s to hold the bodies on cars. And this is from a company called the Model Car Garage, along with these gauge faces that I think we'll put in after we get it all painted. When I first disassembled this car, I made a mental note to myself, hey, I'll take care of these parts so they don't get lost. Well, did you see the windshield there? Yeah, I lost it. I had to buy another one online, which is getting more and more difficult. So watch your parts closely. Here's where we left off last time. Sorta. I have sprayed this with some primer just to see where we are with the body. Looks pretty good so far, but as you'll notice, remember, we added the front end to this car with a material called Milliput. And we're going to have to sand that down and do a little bit of shaping. The really good thing about spraying with primer is you can really evaluate the shape nicely, and you can see where the material being taken off is occurring. One mistake modelers can make, and it's a big one, is to not watch the sharp edges and just go over with that sandpaper overzealously and you get rid of those nice body lines. So you got to be real careful. Go and make a mental note about where these edges are. And as you see, I'm going to do a special thing in just a minute so I don't sand away those very, very precious body lines. Well, look, I've uncovered some areas that need a little bit of extra work. You can see right there is a dimple. And over on this side, we're going to need to use some filler as well. And my favorite filler is this Tamiya putty. First of all, it's a very fine material, so it sands well, but also it dries pretty quickly. Although I advise not to use it really thickly, use it in very thin layers. Having a little tool is very helpful, especially if you have a little piece of styrene sticking around. Make sure you have a straight edge so you can do a little bit of flattening. Now here is one little detail that I need to improve on because this particular car did not have these little walls between the roll bar and the cockpit. So it's a very simple detail and we're going to make sure we take care of it right now. Simple doing little V cuts gets you right down to the basis. And then you build a little tool, look, out of sandpaper and styrene and go in and smooth that off. These little details are really going to make a difference when you're trying to represent a car from a particular point in history. This one is the Bridgehampton race in the spring. And here's how it looks when you reinstall the roll bar. It's going to look pretty sweet, I think, once we get it all painted up and beautiful. Now it's time to tackle the big job of the day, which is this front nose cone. This is going to take several different tasks. Now, if you remember, the whole front end of this car was missing, probably from a previous mishap. Now, to protect that center body line, we draw a line and we're going to sand on the right side and on the left side and totally avoid that nice little line in the front. And there are also two on either side coming down from the fender into the points. Now here's a job that looks easy, but turns out to be a lot more difficult than you would think. These are little flares that were on all four wheels, only on the very early versions of the Chaparral 2. We've got to get rid of those for this Bridgehampton racer. And once you do, you'll start to realize that, it might even make changes in the body. There may not be enough material there to maintain the shape of that wheel well. See, there's a little flat in the back. Now, there is a way to take care of that, so watch. We're going to do it in just a few minutes. Uh-oh, can you feel it? About time for a painful injury from this. Direct correlation to the Band-Aid on the thumb. Don't worry. It was very, very minor, and I take it off by the end of the video. Using some baking soda and a little piece of tape behind the wheel well, I'm going to add some material to do some sanding on and reshape that wheel well. This is a new tool I've started using, this little squeeze bottle. I fill it up with baking soda. A little bottle helps you control that baking soda from getting all over your workbench. Hey, look, I've got another tool of choice. This is really cool. It's a Ryobi grinder that runs on an 18-volt battery. I really like how small and light the handpiece is on this. Well, I guess it's time for more CAD, some cardboard-aided design. I'm trying to make a template that will match the right and left wheel wells. What I do is I mark it with a permanent marker, take off the template, and then go back at it with a grinder, and then sandpaper will finish the job. Here's a simple tip to use your grinder more effectively. Make sure both hands are braced against the work surface and you can move your grinder much, much more gently and much better controlled. Let's take a close-up view of the inside of this wheel well, and you'll see we have the thicknesses also correct. It's amazing when you put cyanoacrid along with baking soda. It must be some kind of a plastic. We don't know what it is, but it works great. Let's make a quick visual review of all the places we need to fill here. You'll see on the back we've got a little divot on the rear section that we'll have to fill in. Let's take care of the rear flares at the back of the car. Simply notice that I have my hands against the work surface and you can just glide that rotary tool right over the fenders. And if you really watch, you make parallel lines all the way around so you know you've controlled that surface. And because I have a deep, abiding love for my fellow man, I've cut out a lot of the sanding, and there has been a whole lot of it. It's kind of mindless, but it's very necessary. We're going to use some surface primer now. Of course, it's Tamiya. I love how thin it is. The thinness of the primer makes sure that you're not going to fill in any of those body shut lines. After we give the primer a few minutes to dry, we can kind of zoom in on the areas that we need to fill again and give a little attention to. Primers like this make it much easier to get the car ready for painting. And at this point, I think we break away and start working on the next episode, which is coming soon. Make sure you subscribe now to the Full Earth Workshop. We'll see you soon.